at ikaw, Panginoon, ay malakas at dakila. Ang taglay mong katangiay, ihahayag ko sa madla. Sa pulpa, sa pagkabata, ako iyong tinuruan. Hanggang ngayon, sinasambit ang gawa mong hinangan. Lagi kong pamukurihan ang iyong
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
In the days of King Herod, king of Judea, there was a priest named Zechariah of the priestly division of Abijah. His wife was from the daughters of Aaron, and her name was Elizabeth. Both were righteous in the eyes of God, observing all the commandments and ordinances of the Lord blamelessly. But they had no child, because Elizabeth was barren, and both were advanced in years. Once when he was serving as priest in his division's turn before God, according to the practice of the priestly service, he was chosen by lot to enter the sanctuary of the Lord to burn incense. Then, when the whole assembly of the people was praying outside at the hour of the incense offering, the angel of the Lord appeared to him, standing at the right of the altar of incense. Zechariah was troubled by what he saw, and fear came upon him. But the angel said to him, "Do not be afraid, Zechariah, because your prayer has been heard. Your wife Elizabeth will bear you a son, and you shall name him John. And you will have joy and gladness, and many will rejoice at his birth, for he will be great in the sight of the Lord. He will drink neither wine nor strong drink. He will be filled with the Holy Spirit, even from his mother's womb. And he will turn many of the children of Israel to the Lord their God. He will go before him in the spirit and power of Elijah to turn the hearts of fathers toward children and the disobedient to the understanding of the righteous, to prepare a people fit for the Lord. Then Zechariah said to the angel, "How shall I know this? For I am an old man, and my wife is advanced in years." And the angel said to him in reply, "I am Gabriel, who stand before God. I was sent to speak to you and to announce to you this good news. But now you will be speechless and unable to talk until the day these things take place, because you did not believe my words, which will be fulfilled at their proper time." Meanwhile, the people were waiting for Zechariah and were amazed that he stayed so long in the sanctuary. But when he came out, he was unable to speak to them, and they realized that he had seen a vision in the sanctuary. He was gesturing to them, but remained mute. Then, when his days of ministry were completed, he went home. After this time, his wife Elizabeth conceived, and she went into conclusion for 5 months, saying, "So has the Lord done for me at a time when he has seen fit to take away my disgrace before others." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Magandang gabi po. Good evening, brothers and sisters. Today is the fifth night of our Simbang Gabi celebration, this Novena Mass. So, if you look at it, the fifth day is like what we see during the week. We have a hump day, is Wednesday. Well, today is the hump day for our Simbang Gabi. It's the fifth day. It's the fifth night. We had 4 Simbang Gabi Masses before this, and we have 4 more after tonight. Okay, so we're at the hump day. We're halfway there. So thank you for being here tonight. Now, if you'll notice, the readings today offer an interesting storyline. We see some parallels between the Old Testament reading from Judges and today's gospel from Luke. In the first reading, we hear the story of a man named Manoah, whose wife was barren, and they had no children. One day, an angel visited Manoah's wife and told her that she would bear a son. She was instructed to avoid unclean food and refrain from wine and strong drink. And her son should not be given a haircut because he will be consecrated to God. It will be through him that the deliverance of Israel from the Philistines will begin. After the angel left, she went to Manoah and told him about the message from the angel. She bore a son, and they named him Samson. We know pretty much a lot about Samson's story, right? Now, one thing, this is a side note, one thing that was interesting to me is that you notice they mentioned Manoah, and you mentioned their son, Samson, but Manoah's wife's name was never mentioned. So when I was looking in, it kind of bothered me. I said, like, why can't they mention her name? So I tried to do a little research, and I found out her name was, get this, Hazelelponi. Maybe that's why they didn't include it, but anyway, the only mention of her name in our Bible is in 1 Chronicles chapter 4, verse 3. But it does not tie in the relationship to Manoah or even to Samson. Her name is just mentioned. So I was curious as to how was her relationship determined? And they point out and they say that she is the mother of Samson and the wife of Manoah. And the reason they say is because it's based on ancient rabbinical writings. So it was a long time ago that it was pointed out that the relationship exists. So I guess we'd have to go to this, the Hebrew people to find out that relationship. But anyway, so she does have a name, okay, and you can find it in our Bible, but it's only mentioned in one place. Now, going to the gospel, if we look at Zechariah, he had spent so many years praying for a child that he already accepted the fact that it wasn't going to happen. He got to the point of being accustomed to God's silence on his plea. So it is no surprise then that when God finally answered his prayer, he was terrified. Just imagine the questions that must have been going round and round in his head as he faced the reality of having a child in his old age. What would he have the energy to keep up with his young child? Did he and Elizabeth have the ability, the know-how, or even the means to train and form a son with such an important mission? And just how radically would this event alter their everyday lives? But the angel assured Zechariah and told him that about the joy that God had in store for him and Elizabeth. He also foretold that the child's mission would bring joy not only to them, but to many other people as well. He even offered some advice by outlining the way of life Zechariah's son was to follow. Just as an angel had instructed Manoah and his wife before Samson's birth. And that was a good thing. Neither Samson nor John the Baptist was an easy child to raise. They both had strong personalities, and they clearly did not blend very well with a crowd. It can be frightening when God answers prayers that we have been making for a long, long time. We suddenly realize what an impact this change will have in our lives. We can no longer count on what has become familiar, even if it wasn't ideal. With this gift come new challenges that invite us to grow and change. Think about being first-time parents. Your lives change dramatically when a child comes, especially in the early years when the child is most dependent. The child becomes the very center of a parent's world. And the way they treat their child will affect every aspect of his or her life. This child will ask questions for which there are no answers and present needs that you may not know how to meet. Your new vocation will be a constant test of and a stress on your relationship with one another and also with the child. It will drive you to depend on God in ways that had never been imagined before. In spite of all this, the new child will bring joy and love, that you will accept every challenge and learn how to weather every storm together. If we can fix our eyes on Jesus, even in the most stressful situations, we'll always find the grace we need to move forward. And finding that grace, we'll also find reason to rejoice. Mary and her loving Son bless us each and every one. Amen.
Please rise. The universal prayer. With confidence in his tender mercy, Let us present our petitions to the Lord.
Our response is, Our Lord, hear our prayer. For the church, that by her faithful preaching of the gospel, she may strengthen the feeble, make firm the weak, and give courage to all those in need. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all nations, that they may heed the message of Christ and embrace the way of the gospel. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the handicapped, the aged, the poor, and the unemployed, that the Lord may strengthen them, and that we may be moved to offer loving support and concern. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For an increase of vocations to the priesthood and religious life, that young men and women may generously respond to the invitation of Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the generously contributed their time, talent, and treasure so that we may have a successful and meaningful celebration of Simbang Gabi, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our faith community, that our celebration of this Eucharist may strengthen and deepen our love and devotion to the Eucharist so that we may be bearers of God's blessings to others. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the sick and their caregivers, for all those on the front line who serve and maintain peace and order, for all of our departed brothers and sisters, that they may be gathered in God's eternal presence, and for all our personal intentions. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God our Father, as we celebrate your Son's birth, draw near, we ask, that you hear and grant the prayers of your adopted sons and daughters, we pray through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Please be seated.
Oh,
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours might be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Look with favor, we pray, O Lord, on the offering we lay upon this altar, that which we bring, despite our weakness, may be sanctified by your power through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, mighty eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For all the orators of the prophet foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by the gift of you already we rejoice in the majesty of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exalted in praise. And so with the angels and archangels, the throne and dominion, with the host of the power of heaven, we sing him of your glory as without end, we acclaim. Indeed, holy Lord, fountain of all holiness, make holy the poor these gifts, we pray, by sending down the Spirit upon it like the dewfall, so it come for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time to stand enteringly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which we pour out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
Sabbath,
We offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation. Giving thanks, you've held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, James, our Bishop, and Paul, our Bishop Emeritus, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command to form fine teaching, we dare to sing. Sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessing hope coming of our Savior Jesus Christ. Faith of your church, grace you grant us peace in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
The Spirit of Serpent being with you, God bless you. Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Bless those called to supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I'm not worthy that you should enter into my roof. Only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Thank you. as we give thanks, Almighty God, for these gifts you have bestowed graciously, arouse in us, we pray, the desire for those yet to come, that we may welcome the nativity of our Savior and honor it with mind and made pure through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hey, I'm good. Before I turn it over to you have announcements, right, Dr. Garcia? I want to thank Dr. Garcia and your whole committee and all the readers, the ushers. I want to thank the Diocesan Choir, Filipino Choir, so we thank you for being here. I cannot thank my brother priest enough for being here, so it's wonderful having you. Father from Woodbridge will be transferred to Palisades, so he'll be replaced. And Father Egert always has to be close to me, so I'm so glad. That's why I made sure your chair was right next to my chair, Father Egert. So I thank you for that. Deacon, outstanding homily. Thank you. Very, very nice. I want to thank the altar service from St. Helena's and the altar server from the cathedral. So we thank you for your presence, for being here to serve. And if I left anyone out, I just want to say that this is my in my 15th year of being here. And even through the pandemic, we've had a beautiful mass on this beautiful 9-day novena. So I thank you all for being here. And I'm turning it over to our chairperson and the head of our Filipino apostolate here at St. Helena's. Do you want us to sit down? Is this going to be long? Because I see a lot of words on the paper. Yeah.
It will not be long, Father, because you stole my fire by thanking everyone. So thank you very much.
Okay.
But most of all, we would like to thank Father Anthony, our pastor here at St. Helena, for all of his support, hospitality, and welcoming. Welcoming Simbang Gabi here so graciously. Thank you so much, Father. God bless you. Also, we'd like to thank all of you for coming near and far who found your way to Simbang Gabi here at St. Helena with gifts of love, peace, and joy in your hearts to share amongst each other. And as I said, we thank everyone who participated in this beautiful Mass. Please join us again tomorrow, December 20th, for Simbang Gabi in any of the following three parishes: Nativity of the Lord in Monroe at 6 p.m., St. Cecilia in Monmouth Junction at 7 p.m., or St. James in Woodbridge at 7 p.m. We invite you to follow this Simbang Gabi journey through its conclusion on December 23rd, when the Most Reverend James Cecchio, Bishop of Metuchen, will be the presider and homilist in a Eucharistic celebration at St. Francis Cathedral at 7 p.m. For those of you who prefer early morning masses, Misa de Gallo is celebrated daily at 5 a.m. at St. Ladislaus Church in New Brunswick from now until December 24. At this time, we would like for you to pick up a to-go refreshment bag at either of two locations, in the breezeway here to my right or in the front of the church down the aisles. And now let us prepare with joyful hearts for the coming of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Thank you so much for coming tonight.
Thank you. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May my God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. Glorify the Lord by your love.
Thanks be to God.
Have a wonderful evening, everyone. And I believe we have one more song, so let's hit it.
Thank you.
God.